I'm sure you're realizing that you can no longer ignore AI. So I'm going to address 10 most commonly asked questions. Asked by whom? Oh, I am doing so many sessions with a wide range of people, starting from business leaders to students. And these questions, by and large, are common across them. And the first one, which comes to mind, sometimes spoken, sometimes unspoken, is it a threat to my existence? Is it going to take away my job? Is it going to replace me? So let's address that. By the way, whatever I'm talking about is generically about AI, but specifically about ChatGPT and Copilot in Microsoft. For example, in Word, Copilot, it can look at a very long document and summarize it quickly. Now, that's a great feature. I would otherwise have spent 20, 30 minutes doing it manually. Is it going to replace my job? No, because that summary is something you still have to read. You have to cross-check because it may miss something. And what to do based on that summary, that AI doesn't know. AI doesn't know who you are, what is your job profile, what are your products, what are your customers. That's you. So it is only an assistant to you. It's an adjunct to you. It's not your competitor. So get that very clear. Maybe some repetitive or creative tasks it can do much better than you. Very good. You should take it positively and use it to your advantage. That's all there is to it. Next, is it exposing my ignorance or inefficiency? Yes, because AI has given you a better, faster, smarter way of doing something which either didn't exist earlier or you didn't know it existed. In either case, your process was worse than what AI has given you. So in that sense, inefficiency did get exposed, but don't take it negatively. Now the efficiency has improved, you saved some time. Use that time to do something positive, constructive, and value-adding. That's what I mean by using AI to your advantage. The next related concern is too much of use of AI. Is it dumbing me down? And I would definitely say yes. In fact, so much automation available in the world, it's not bad. But if you rely too much on it, some of the core skills which we have as humans are getting lost. Let's take the example of summarizing the document. You give the document to AI. AI summarized it. It has given you few points. Now, those few points you are reading for the first time. You don't know how those points were derived. Now, compare that with you yourself summarizing the document. You would go through practically every line of the document. You may skim some paragraphs. That's okay. But still, the amount of imbibing you will have done in the process of summarizing the document is going to be much, much better than you looking at the auto-generated summary for the first time. So there is a qualitative difference. And if you lose the ability to look at some long text and summarize it, that's bad for you. Because everywhere AI is not applicable, you still need that skill. So use AI, but don't lose core skills. Another relatable example is, everyone is saying now because of ChatGPT and AI, the user interface is going to be only speech. I will speak everything. Now remember, earlier also, we had a thought that we will stop using typing and we'll only use speech to text as a method of interacting with PCs. Has it happened fully? No. Everyone knows you can't get away without typing something on a PC or Mac today. But despite knowing that very clearly, how many of us have actually learned typing? Very few. And we don't even realize the disadvantage it has. Because when you're typing consciously, half your attention is finding the keys and correcting mistakes, which basically is reducing your concentration and it's reducing the quality of your output, or it is taking longer to produce better output, which is essentially wasting your life. So learn typing. Exactly the same way I'm saying, look at AI positively, take the advantage, and don't lose your human advantage in the process. All right, so far so good. But the next question is, my company has not done much about AI. What should I do as a person about AI? That's a good thought. Look at what your job description is. Make a list of activities you do on a daily, weekly, whatever basis. And then in the second column, you say and think, is this activity going to be better done by some AI? Then write it down there, explore that. If it is applicable, use it. If it is not under your control, present that as a case study to your management. Let them approve it. So that's how you break down your life into pieces or activities which can be improved by AI. Step one. Then the second step is to look at things which AI could not improve. Right? Everything AI cannot do. So some things you are better at doing. Now, those are the things which are going to make you as a person valuable despite stiff competition from AI. So those are the skills you have to proactively learn deeper now, because that is going to differentiate you in the increasingly automated world. So now let's look at what are the skills you as a human being have which are unlikely to be surpassed or even matched by AI. And that's important. One of the most important is emotional intelligence, interpersonal relations, leadership, motivation. All these require you to understand human beings in the first place, how to communicate, understand body language, understand responses, react to them. All that is impossible for AI to do. So that's your domain, and build expertise in that. Of course, other aspect is things which require dexterity and physical skill. Robots and AI is nowhere near that right now. So physical skills will continue to rule. So what are the things I should learn in AI? Now, that answer can be very specific depending on what you do and what is your expertise. But these are some generic things I feel everyone can benefit from. One is, instead of going to ChatGPT, you should use Bing Chat, because that uses ChatGPT and DALL-E 3 behind the scenes, free of cost. In that, if you have Office 365, log in using your corporate account, so you get data protection as well. This also gives you image to text generation as well, because behind the scenes, it is using DALL-E 3. Bing itself has a visual search which uses AI, which many people don't know. Google also has similar, so you have an image, and based on the image, it can recognize the contents and search based on that. Very useful. If you have more sophisticated use cases, then of course, by all means, you should use ChatGPT by itself. And if you are seriously using ChatGPT, I would suggest you take the Plus subscription, because ChatGPT 4 is really powerful, especially for things like voice processing, data analytics, built-in images, and more. Within ChatGPT, there are 3 million plus GPTs, or mini value adds as we call them. Learn the important ones in your context. I know it's a painful exercise to go through millions and find what is useful, but at least look at key areas of importance and shortlist some of them and use them proactively. I use, for example, a YouTube summarizer or a PDF summarizer, data analytics one, very common GPTs. The next one, if you have Office, in Teams, there is a speaker coach, and in PowerPoint, there is a presentation coach. These are AI-based features which are really well designed. They'll actually improve the way you speak and the way you present. Use that to improve your delivery skills. If you are using Office extensively, even without Copilot, there are many AI features. Have a look at those. This video will give you the details. And finally, use Copilot. Even if the company is not sponsoring, you take a personal version, one license, and try it out and check whether it significantly adds value to your day-to-day work. Now, another related topic is, okay, I'm using AI to generate images or some creative text. Who has the copyright? So currently, there is no copyright issue. You can freely use it. In fact, for Copilot users, Microsoft even indemnifies its customers against litigation. But that is as of now. It's an evolving field, so check the latest status whenever you have this question in mind. Next question is actually not frequently asked, but it should be asked. Every AI tool you use will have something in small font written saying it may be inaccurate, or it may be imaginating, hallucinating, something like that. So it's not perfect. And because it is not perfect, however great the output might be, you have to cross-check whatever AI is telling you. And that takes time. You can't use another AI to cross-check this AI. It doesn't make any sense. So this is an example where natural intelligence is required to make use of artificial intelligence smartly. Now, the final question is something which people realize after working on AI for some time, but let me tell it to you upfront. I give some input to AI, it gives me some output. Now, the question is, if I give the same prompt 2 days later, will I get the same output? Probably not. So the output of AI is generated every time you give it the input. So it is not repeatable. And you have to live with that, understand that. And it also sometimes means that you don't take just the first output. Try a couple of iterations and then choose the best. This is my perception of what people want to know. But if I miss something, feel free to put it in comments. I will be happy to address that as well. So that's it for now. I have a lot of videos on Copilot and AI. Have a look at those before you go.